held in Beijing. 2008 Beijing Summer Olympic is the game of 29 Olympiad, which involving 28 different types of sport from four competing. Moreover, this event brings the motto of One World, One Dreams. The motto of this event had completely reflect the essence and the value of Olympic spirit. In the past, there were only a total of 14 nations were represented by 241 athletes during the opening of the modern Olympics in 1896 in Athens. Though the participating in Beijing Olympic in China facilitated a record of 205 participating countries with a total of 11,468 athletes. The opening ceremony will held at Beijing National Stadium, which also known as Bird Nest, during the 8th of August 2008. So I will pass it to Chen.
Next, I will present the negative impacts of Beijing Olympic Games. So I will present for the first. So the first impact for Beijing Olympics 2018 is social cultural impact. First point is improvement in traffic management of Beijing roads from RedCom 2018. The improvement in traffic management of Beijing roads is the first half of hosting a green Olympic, while road construction to solve traffic congestion is still pending. Interviewees from one neighborhood have already begun taking advantage of new paths built for the venues to be set up here. A lot of them were, however, not optimistic that green and high-tech Olympics would eventually prevent traffic issues. There were interviews made from the food provider industry illustrated this opinion by saying that if the three themes set for 2018 Olympic Games are realized and traffic in Beijing is improved, more tourists will be attracted to Beijing. More people mean more vehicles and traffic congestion again, they admitted. However, they could not think for a better solution. The next point is the residents uprooted because of the planning for Olympic Games. To help an Olympic event is a big hit, but there are consequences to face. The expensive scale spatial rebuilding was joined by recomposing of urban-private landscape in the types of urban redevelopment and beautification programs. Broken down neighborhoods in focal areas were liable to discount devastation and redevelopment. Clearing a path for the line worker workplaces, extravagance homes and business premises. Surviving noteworthy quarters, for example, Xiamen, a notable commercial center south of Forbidden City, experienced what local people agreed as takeover, which includes polarization and recreation to impersonate all compositional staff. The last point will be heavy projects approved by government influence beggars. So heavy projects approved by government always influence beggars. Next, Beijing's quest to build New Beijing, New Olympics came with a heavy emphasis on environmental improvement projects. Different government activities were actualized, which could allude as social purifying to ensure social nuisance were expelled from Beijing urban space. These measures influenced beggars and additional road sellers that pulled a substantial number of vagrants without legal license. Migrant workers and the development business were additionally delayed to remain in the city as building destinations were incidentally shut to decrease air pollution. Inward going by beggars likewise demoralized because of extreme personalities check forced by security powers. Next is the social culture recommendation. The first point is holding an event in existing facilities. So to cure the problem faced by the neighborhood living in the areas, which took down during the creation of Beijing Olympics 2008, there will be a few ways. First, holding events in existing facilities around the world would allow Olympics to capitalize on some of the world's most iconic locations. While removing the excessive construction and disruption caused by the host cities, This way, China residents can continue living in their own place peacefully without ending up homeless and hatred towards the event. The next point will be hosting the event in one location. Another way is hosting the event in one location. The hosting of Olympic is not easy as it is a mega event and high cost. It also consumes land capacity. Building Olympic is a constant. Building Olympic in a constant location can save cost, save environment, and also save people from losing their home. Next, I'll pass to Kylie.
Hi, I would like to present the environmental issue of the Olympic 2008. So there is a rapid development brings the impacts to Mother Nature, according to Tupi and Gilbert. And then there's researchers said the economy implication of the environmental impacts have been neglected. And nowadays the sports events are getting bigger and bigger, also mentioned by Woodlet and Sukrash. Okay, and then many people assume that nature is an unlimited renewable resource, and it is a reason that the environmental costs are always ignored in most of the decision making process. And there is many negative impacts caused by the Olympics 2008, which are bad air and water quality, noise caused by heavy traffic, overcrowding due to result in huge amounts of waste and energy use. Alastair Jamieson mentioned that the Beijing Olympics 2008 were the most polluted games ever. Some researchers also say 1/5 of the time of the athletes were revealed to the high level of coarse particle, which is very dangerous to our bodies. WHO also assumed that the limits were exceeded as scientists figured out the level were 1/3 higher than Chinese government expert mentioned by Jamieson 2009. In July 2008, thousands of workers worked to clear algae from the Yellow Sea for sailing races. However, according to Migoski 1995, these thoughts have been mainly rejected since 1960 as the negative impacts of the Olympic 2008 are raised up. And then people are nowadays are more concerned of the environmental issue.
Alright, the first recommendation for negative environmental impact of Beijing Olympic Games towards the host area is they can plant more trees and create more green space for residents to reduce the rate of carbon monoxide pollution that exhausts from the factories, vehicles, coal burning houses and so on. And secondly, to decrease the air pollution issues, the city should expand on rail public transport to encourage people to take the rail transport, yet to solve the transport problem, the biggest problem in Beijing, which is traffic jam, and also reduce the level of smog in the host area. Furthermore, another recommendation of negative environmental impacts of Beijing Olympics Games are implement tax incentive to encourage people to buy cleaner vehicles to reduce the exhaustion of carbon monoxide from vehicles. And according to the Guardian News, there are over 2,000 of buses and 5,000 of taxis in the city has been upgraded and also replaced with a cleaner vehicles, which can help Beijing to move into a cleaner and healthier city. And lastly, the last recommendation for environmental impact is Beijing is an urbanization city which having a lot of factories and also building sites. So according to China Daily, if the level of air quality turns bad, all the factories and also building sites may be forced to close down during the Olympic Games. So it can help to cut off the smoke and also bring out a good image to the tourists who visit to China.
So now it's been my part. the third impact. The first are the economic negative impacts. The first one is inflation. So after the event done and during the events, according to Pettinger in 2018, inflation was happening in the country of Beijing and China. So this inflation is caused by the increased amount of labor workers and also the tourists who were come to attend for this event. So when the demand in the markets of goods increase, but the supply is still remain the same, the supplier might not have enough of goods to supply to the demand market. So that a cost pool inflation being caused by this event. So the second and the third one, infrastructure has been abandoned and the cost of maintaining the infrastructure is high for the event. The cost of building a Beijing Bird Nest National Stadium is $460 million, and every year the government have to pay around $11 million for maintaining the stadium. Here comes the recommendation. The first recommendation to solve the problem of inflation is government have to implement contractional monetary policy. By controlling the contractional money policy, the government will control three main factors from the country. First of all is open market operation. The government will use this system to sell the security, which also called by bonds, to the central markets, so that central markets central bank has less money to supply to the market. The second one, controlling the rate of reserve requirement. This rate of reserve requirement is means by the rate that a bank have to reserve to lend out to the market. And the third one, control the discount rate. The discount rate over here is means by the interest rate from central bank lending out to the commercial bank. So after using this contractional monetary policy, there is less money supply to the market. When there is less money supply to the market, the residents and people in Beijing has less money to use, so they will try to save more money. So in the goods, market goods, there will increase of the goods. So the second recommendation for the second impact and the third impact is infrastructure builder have to build the building for second purpose instead of temporary event. For examples like Beijing Water Cube, they doesn't use it and abandon it. They transform it and renovate it into a new park, the new water theme park. And also from one examples from Brazil, the volleyball arena, which called as Future Arena. After the event ends, they transform it into secondary school. So I'm done with my part. I'll pass it to Shannon.
Okay, so now we're going to discuss about how organizing Olympic Games can benefit to the local business community in China. So it's undeniable that by organizing these Olympic Games, we can create a lot of job opportunities for the locals, especially during the development and also in long term. Why would I say it's in long term? Because according to Chen Jian, the president of Beijing Olympic Economic Research Association, it's estimated that on 2008, we'll have China will have around 600,000 of foreign visitors and 2.5 million domestic visitors from China to visit Beijing. And also, that the number of foreign visitors of Beijing will grow from 8 to 9% annually in the decade following the games because of Olympic Games itself. So it will create a long-term opportunity for the locals there. Secondly, will be the increased revenues because the travelers who will visit to Beijing, of course, they will spend in their local markets and especially on their local manufactured items in China. As example, their souvenirs, their local-made tea or something like that. And then the third one will be increase in local business. The travelers who travel to Beijing for the Olympic Games will surely utilize their local facilities. For example, their restaurants, their hotels, their shopping malls, and from that, they will increase the revenue created for the local business and also benefit for the locals in Beijing and China. And the fourth one will be increased revenue for traveler service providers. As example, the travel service agent according to the China National Tourism Administration, Beijing had 3.8 million foreign visitors arrival in 2007, up to 11.8% over 2006, and China had 42.4 million foreign visitors arrival on 2007, up to 20.8% over 2006. So it's obvious that it had a significant increase due to the Olympic Games. And after China won the bid for after China won its Olympic bid from WTO, the country has reduced the hotel ownership restrictions. Starting in 2002, the foreign investors could own a majority stake in hotels. And in 2016, wholly foreign-owned hotels were permitted. So this can also increase the job opportunity for the locals and also create more revenue for the locals. Okay, that's it for my part.
So in the conclusion, the 2008 Summer Olympic Games had huge impact on the Beijing city. Negative impacts such as bad air, water quality, and noise that caused by a big scale of sport event can be solved by creating more green space and promote public transport. Holding event in existing facility instead of recomposing the off-urban private landscape could prevent broken down neighborhood in local area. And hosting Olympic Games can bring benefit for the local business community in many ways, such as attract foreign travelers around the world and increase the revenue of tourism business in Beijing. Besides that, hosting Olympic Games can bring benefits for the foreign investor, such as the nation already decreased the hotel restriction for the foreign investor, and this also will help the economy of the local cities. Thank you.
Here comes the reference.
Any questions?
So other than holding event in the same place, is there any other recommendation in sociocultural term?
So from based on the impacts, main impacts from the social cultural impacts towards Beijing 2018, the main problem of the impacts towards social cultural reason is there is not enough space for building the sports centers. So instead of using one stadium, there is quite less of recommendation could be provided for solving this problem. Unless they renovate maybe like a secondary school into a sports stadium for temporary use. After the event ends, then we use it back as secondary school or primary school.
Okay. Based on the explanation given, hosting the event in one location, I just want to clarify, hosting the event in one location means the event of Olympic event hosting in one specific country for every summer Olympics, or you mean the stadiums just now?
Hosting in one particular place, like an island, in somewhere, okay, haven't manufactured island. So this could save a lot of resources and prevent people from losing their homes. Because every year you host the event in the same place, right? So the same place, you can prevent all this from happening.
Okay, that's such a good recommendation. But as we turn back based on the history, we know that it is already practiced a decade ago. So we know that they are rotating the country and everything. It's only in terms of giving the recommendations, I want you to highlight how to use back the area as mentioned by your, you know, by other presenters just now. Okay?
So based on our recommendation, it's maybe like, after 2018, Beijing held the Olympics. In future, maybe like 2024, we only held this Olympic events at Beijing. Is it of using other states such as Shanghai, Sichuan, Hong Kong, and others?
Okay, so instead of using other area, maybe for the coming years, if in case Beijing still hosting, so you are actually recommend in terms of giving at the same area in the country. Am I right?
Yeah.
Okay, so as for that, a little bit enhancement in terms of elaboration.